Good morning, students. Today we start a new chapter of grammar portion, punctuation. So, what is punctuation? You can see a punctuation mark is a mark or sign used in writing to separate sentence and their elements and to clarify meaning. So, these punctuation marks are used in a writing to separate the sentences and to clarify the meaning of the sentences. Here, the most common punctuation marks in English are, you can see, these are the punctuation marks, whatever we use in our writing. So, full stop, this is the full stop. Then, comma, it is comma. Semicolon, this is the semicolon, you can see. Colon, double dot, that is inside the bracket, that is colon. And quotation mark. Sorry, question mark. This is the question mark. You all know what is question mark. We use question mark in interrogative sentences. Exclamation mark. This is the exclamation mark. And inverted commas or quotation mark. So, this is the single inverted comma, single quotation mark or double quotation mark. So here it is a single quotation mark and this is the double quotation mark. So these are the quotation mark. Parenthesis means bracket and dash. Okay, this is dash. First of all, we will discuss about the full stop. Full stop represents the greatest pause. It represents the greatest pause and separation. Here, number one, it is used to mark the end of a declarative or an imperative sentence. So here, this full stop is used in declaratively simple sentences, either that is positive or negative. In the end of the sentence, we use this full stop. Okay. Dear, patient, gentle, noble name. So name is the name of the person. He is dear, patient, gentle and noble. These are the qualities of them. Was them. So this is the simple sentence. And when a sentence completes, at the end of the sentence, we put full stop. Then in imperative sentences also, we use full stop, be quick, and then full stop. Make haste, then full stop. So in imperative sentences also full stop is used, and in declarative means simple sentences, in negative and positive, at the end of the sentence we use full stop. Dear students, second use of full stop in internet and email addresses, it is used. Means full stop is used in internet and email addresses. Example number one, here you can see www. So dot is that is the full stop, and yes.group.. So these are the full stop here. These dots are full stop. So full stop is also used in internet and email addresses. Then in the second example also, email yes.vsnl.. So here this dot is full stop. And then next use of full stop can be used in abbreviations, but they are often omitted in modern British English. So abbreviation means when we write something, means some name in short, okay, like BA, okay, so BA, here B dot A dot, so these dot are full stop, B dot A dot, but in modern British English, it is omitted, it is removed, okay, and then we write like this, BA. Second, USA, U dot, S dot, A dot. So these are the full stop here. But in modern English, we write U S A like this. Next example, M P or M dot P dot. So in modern English, we write like this, M P. Next, A M or A dot M dot. Okay. So A dot M dot. These dots are the full stop. But in modern British English, we write A N direct. Next, we will discuss about comma. The comma represents the shortest pause. But full stop represents the greatest pause. So these comma represent the shortest pause. First, to separate a series of words in the same construction. So series of words like he lost lands, money, reputation. So three things are here, and these are the same construction, and these are the series of words: land, money, and reputation. So to separate these words, we use comma, and the last word is joined by N. Here lands, comma, money, comma, reputation, and after that here the last word is joined by N. That means to separate the series of words we use comma. Next number, it was a long, dull, and wearisome journey. So long, comma, dull. Two things are here, two words are here, and to separate both the words we use comma here. And the last word wearisome is added with N. Means whenever we separate the series of words, now this series of words are separated by comma, but the last word is joined by N, that is not separated by comma. Okay. Next use of comma is to separate each pair of words connected by N. Means if the pair of the words are connected by N, to separate, you know, those pair of words we use comma. Here in schools and colleges. So here colleges and schools, both the words are connected by N, that is other pair. In fleet and army, this is also fleet and army, both are connected by N. So this is another pair. And discipline means success. So discipline means success here, that is separated. Yeah. So all the pair here in schools and colleges, in fleet and army, discipline means success. So these are separated by comma. Is the pair of words which are connected by A, separated by comma. Next is example, high and low. So both high and low are connected by A. Rich and poor, both words connected by A. And wise and foolish, connected by A. Must all die. So all phrases, means all pair, you know, high and low, rich and poor, both are separated by comma here. And rich and poor, wise and foolish, both are separated by comma. Means to separate the pair of words connected with N. Now, it is in these things we use comma. Comma is used. Two work of words used in addressing people. To mark off words used in addressing people. Means when something is addressing people, any people here in this example, Gopal, coming. So we are addressing to Gopal here. After Gopal, we will use come. Means to mark off words. So here to mark this word Gopal, comma is used. Means to mark off words used in addressing people. And here we are addressing, or we address the word Gopal. And after Gopal, we will use comma. In the next example, Kamini, Gopal, Shikir. So here Kamini, Gopal. Okay, we are addressing here, we address here Gopal as well as Kamini. So after Kamini and after Gopal, both the words we use comma to separate. Next, use of comma before and after participle phrase, provided that the phrase might be expanded into a sentence and it not used in a merely qualifying sense. Here, that means before and after a participle phrase, provided that the phrase might be expanded. So here in this example, Caesar, having conquered his enemies, returned to Rome. Okay, so after and before a participle, here having is used, this is the perfect participle, having plus third form of the verb is used here. So before and after a participle phrase, okay, which is that is used, means that provided that the phrase might be expanded, and here phrase might be expanded, return to Rome. So by this phrase, it is this extended or expanded. Okay, so before the participle phrase we use, before and after the participle phrase we use comma. Next, before and after words, phrase or clause let into the body of a sentence. So here before and after the words, phrase and clause. Here he did not. This is the phrase, he did not, and after that we use here comma. However, gained his object. So before this, gained his object comma is used. So before and after words, phrases and clause we use comma. In the next example, his behavior. This is also phrase. This is in complete sense. To say the least, that is also phrase because it doesn't give the complete meaning. Here was very good. So before and after the phrase and clause we use comma. Here next use of comma strings to indicate the omission of a word, especially a verb. So to indicate omission of word, especially a verb, you can see Rama received a pen. So Rama received, here the verb is received. Rama received a pen, Hari comma a watch. So Hari a watch, that means Hari received a watch. Okay, so same verb should come here. So here the verb is omitted, and when the verb is omitted, when we omit the verb, we use comma. Okay, in the next example, he will succeed, you never. Okay, so in place of succeed, you succeed never, that means in place of verb we use comma here. Like he will succeed, so here the succeed, the verb succeed is used, but after the verb, after the subject, verb is not used. In place of verb comma is used, means the verb is omitted. To mark of next use, to mark of direct quotation from the rest of the sentence. To mark a direct quotation from the rest of the sentence, you can see here example, exactly so said Alice. So exactly so, this is in quotation mark, and to separate this, the words which is in quotation mark, you know, from the other part of the sentence, we use comma. Means exactly so, it is in quotation mark and it is separated from the other part of the sentence. And to separate this, the word which is in quotation mark, you know, from the other part of the sentence, we use comma. In the next example, you can see he said to his disciple, watch and pray. So watch and pray, the words are here in quotation mark, and to separate these words from the other part of the sentence which are in quotation mark, then we use comma. So here both the parts of the sentence are separated by comma, that the other part of the sentence and which is in quotation mark. Next use, to separate a long sentence from the verb. So to separate the long subject, here you can see what is long subject. The justice of a sentence. Sorry, injustice. The injustice of the sentence pronounced upon the great scientist and discoverer. So this is the long sentence from start, from beginning to here, and from this from beginning to discover. This is the long sentence, that is the subject part. And with that subject part is separated, here is now evident to us all. Okay, the justice of the sentence pronounced upon the great scientist and discoverer. So that part, that subject, long sentence subject is separated from the verb part, is now evident to us all. That is the verb part. Next, ninth number, to separate an adjective clause that is not restrictive in meaning, but it coordinates with the principal clause. Here, okay, to separate an adjective clause. So here, who is a surgeon? My uncle, who is a surgeon, has been to America several times. So this, that part is separated from the main clause. Okay, principal clause. Who is a surgeon? Okay, that part is separated from by comma.